But do you think that it's the inability of the party to project one leader? In the past, you've had Rajnath Singh, you've had Kalyan Singh. This time, there seem to be several leaders in the fray with no one clear face behind whom the troops rally. Do you believe it's the lack of an army commander that is costing the BJP dear in these elections?
I think that it will be oversimplistic analysis, Rahul. Does the Congress have a CM choice? Is Rahul Gandhi the PM's candidate or the CM's candidate? Let me ask you a question. You never ask this question from Congress party, do you? The BJP contests, obviously leaders are important. We'll project at the appropriate time. But it is the BJP's presence in the entire Uttar Pradesh because of reasons that they have been very strong there. And today let me inform your viewers, in 1967, the then Jan Sangh has won 120 Vidhan Sabha seats. They have been traditionally very strong in Uttar Pradesh. Yes, other factors intervened. Some of our weaknesses were also there. We have to reclaim it, and I am sure the people getting fed up with the misrule of Mulayam Singh Yadav and current corrupt misrule of Madam Mayawati will revert to us, and price rise is concerned, national governance is concerned. They have seen what Congress has done.
Okay, I want to put one question to Praveen Aaron before I come to caste arithmetic and which way the castes are moving in these elections. While 66% of the people in Uttar Pradesh favor change, that vote isn't coming to the Congress because people in Uttar Pradesh don't believe that the Congress party is a real contender for power. Therefore, while it could be drawing Muslim votes, Dalit votes, because it's not really seen to be in the fray, therefore it's not really benefiting from the anti-incumbency, which is hurting Mayawati.
See, I think same people are aware that in 2009 also, during the parliament election, the recently held parliament election or last parliament election, nobody was believing that Congress will be able to retain. People were saying, the analysts were saying, the poll research, poll surveys were saying that it will be difficult for Congress even to maintain the last tally of 8 or 9 seats. Then look what we got. We got 21 and 22 seats with Raj Babbar winning at the strongest hold of the Samajwadi party. So people also say that Congress is going to surprise. The way it surprised in the parliamentary election, in the Lok Sabha elections, it is going to surprise everybody, including the poll surveys in the assembly polls. And let me tell you very clearly that all the things, including the misrule, the lack of governance, corruption, all this has people of Uttar Pradesh have seen during the last 22 years, and they have suffered at the hands of the BJP, the Samajwadi Party and Congress. And let me tell you, despite of all this, the FDI thing, I would say, I am of the opinion that media is highly against Congress, or at least playing in the hands of the opposition parties or whoever is campaigning against the Congress. So despite of all round attack, let me clarify that people of Uttar Pradesh are seeing through each and everything, and they are going to vote for Congress.
Okay.
And you will see the entire anti-incumbency vote. Let me complete. The entire anti-incumbency vote will go in favor of Congress, and you will see in the soon-to-be elections.